Get ready to match the stars from Carter Country, Richard Paul, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Joanne Harris, from Family Feud, Richard Dawson, and Betty White, as we play the star-studded big money match game, PM.
That's very kind of you. I thank you very much for joining us here, whether you are live or in person. And I know you're live. They're here in person. And you're here in person. Aren't you a beautiful bunch?
Aren't we?
Shall we get right to it?
Sure.
We got two players, Kevin McCune and Sherry Cloutier. All right. Welcome to both of you. Let's find out a little bit about each of you before we begin. Sherry, may we begin with you?
Yes, I'm presently employed as a Playboy Bunny at the Los Angeles Playboy Club.
We've never had one of those, have we?
No, we're Richard.
I have to say.
We're what? Yes?
That's just about it. I'm single, 20 years old, and I'm really thrilled to be here. Thank you.
Well, we're delighted to have you here with us, Sherry. Good luck to you. And you, sir?
Oh, my name's Kevin. Hi, Gene.
You're Kevin.
That's me, man.
No kidding.
I'm single. I'm a graduate of San Diego State University, and I'm going to be going to law school up in the Northwest this fall. And I'd like you to know that my fraternity voted you the second best dresser of a game show MC in the country.
Second best? hold everything. Second best?
Well, all the others tied for first.
And you expect to win some money here?
Just kidding.
I know you're just kidding there. You sure are a kidder. No, I'm only kidding. Well, good luck to both of you. You're a lovely... Have you met Sherry?
Oh, yeah.
Yes, we know.
She's 20, you know.
Oh, yes.
She's single.
Oh, yeah.
Yes. He has good prospects. Law school graduate and all that. On Match Game PM here, each of you will have three opportunities to match as many of our stars as you possibly can. The one who's done that most often at the end of the third round will be the winner and will go on to play that big audience super match, which can pay off over $20,000. Wow-wee. Here we go, Sherry. You want A or B?
B, please.
B for Sherry. It says, a TV guide listing for you. Sunday night, CBS. All in the Family. And the little synopsis says, Archie is shocked when he learns that Edith is leaving him to marry blank. To marry blank.
What is it again?
Archie is shocked to find that Edith is leaving him to marry blank. All right, here we go. TV Guide listing, Sunday night, CBS, All in the Family. Archie is shocked when he learns that Edith is leaving him to marry...
Mike Stivic. That's the son-in-law.
Mike Stivic is already married.
That's okay. That's why she was shocked.
Oh, I see. That's why Archie was shocked. He learned that Edith... Hey, Edith, you're going to marry the meathead?
What is Edith? That'd be some kind of incest there. I think it would be bad enough for Archie if she married Sammy Davis Jr.
That would shock him. All right. You remember the episode with Sammy Davis? Yes. Okay.
They're all wrong. She's leaving him to marry John Amos because he's left, you know.
That's right.
And he's on the market.
Okay, that would make Archie furious. What do you say to this?
I chose the Incredible Hulk.
Huh?
The Incredible Hulk.
I'm gonna save that.
I'm gonna press it in my scrapbook because it says the Incredible Hunk.
I've been ill. I don't watch TV much.
Yes, he does. Archie is shocked when he learns that Edith is leaving him to marry.
Well, Sherry and I are equally demented because I said Meathead.
Meathead. Let's do it. Okay, one for Sherry. Now, tell us, what would shark Arch?
Well, I know if
She married Mr. Jefferson.
Mystery! Yeah. Oh, boy.
Mr. Jefferson.
That would really do it to her. Okay, so she picks up one. Kevin, let's see how you do with yours. Yours says, Bobby said, the T-shirt craze is really wild. Now, today, I saw a girl wearing a T-shirt with a pizza on the front. And she had the biggest blanks I ever saw. Big pizza. Big pizza. Okay, Kevin. Bobby said, the T-shirt craze. Crave. I just had some pizza. The T-shirt craze is really wild. Today I saw a girl wearing a T-shirt with a pizza on the front. She had the biggest blanks I ever saw.
Crust.
Crust! I mean, it's a most amusing answer, but I don't think you're going to win with it, Kevin.
There's a lot of crust saying that, I tell you that. No, she had a big anchovy.
Biggest anchovy! Anything in the line that would decorate a pizza would be acceptable.
He's
here.
He's in front of you now, Bob. He's right in front. That's it.
He's talking to you.
Where? Oh, did you want
no,
my...
it's over here. Oh, here I am, right here.
Well, of course. The biggest of sausages.
Biggest sausages. Well, that's not too thrilling an answer, but sausages.
Back at the anchovy.
Back at two anchovies, one sausage. I thought you were going to say something else, Chuck.
What?
No, he's always kidding about something. I'll tell you later. Go ahead.
Thank you so much. Okay. Pepperonis?
Pepperonis!
I don't know what you're talking about.
All right.
Sausages.
The T-shirt craze really wild today. I saw a girl wearing a T-shirt with a pizza on the front. She had the biggest anchovies I ever saw. Or crusts.
Exactly what I said.
Anchovies is an anchovy. Well, he said crust. What do you I say?
Takes a lot of crust to say anchovies. You know, pepperonis.
Pepperonis. Some pepperonis. Okay, so there we are at the end of round one, and it's 1-0. Favor Sherry. Round two coming up. But first, this. Now, here we go to round two. Bing and Sherry, since you're ahead, we'll ask you to go first. You may have A or B again.
I'd like B again.
B again. Okay, one person lays out, and that is Joanne. Oh, okay. George said, times are really getting strange. Yesterday, I opened up a copy of The Blank, and it had a nude centerfold. Times are getting strange. Yesterday, I opened up a copy of The Blank, and it...
Of
The Blank, and it had a nude centerfold.
P-E-R-O-N-I-S.
The pepperoni is finished.
Throw it in there. Busy.
George said, times are really getting strange. Yesterday, I opened up a copy of The Blank, and it had a nude centerfold.
The L.A. Times?
The what?
L.A. Times.
The L.A. Times. Would that be strange?
Yeah.
Richard, what would be really strange?
Well, I have something a little stranger, Sherry. If you found a nude centerfold in the Christian Science Monitor.
That would be strange. Really strange. Yes?
I don't want anybody to think that there's anything flippant in this answer. I said the Bible.
Don't lie to me.
Okay, we won't.
I said a boring answer, the Family Circle.
The Family Circle magazine. That's the one you buy in the grocery stores there that all of the ladies buy. What about to you, Richard? What do you say to this? Yesterday I opened up a copy of The Blank and had a nude centerfold.
Who's right to Brett? Bible.
The Bible. All right. Yes, ma'am.
Let your fingers do the walking through the yellow
pages. The phone book. Oh, that's a good one. The telephone book. Wouldn't that be weird?
The phone book.
No.
Yellow pages, especially. Are you ready?
You bet.
Okay. The mama kangaroo said to her son, son, how many times do I have to tell you, don't put your blank in your pouch? Mama kangaroo, speaking to you. Son, how many times do I have to tell you, don't put your blank in your pouch? Yes. Here we go, Kevin. The mama kangaroo said to her son, how many times do I have to tell you, don't put your blank in your pouch?
Head.
What?
Head.
Head. You're still in there, Sherry. Even though you only got one, you're still hanging in there.
Well, he was just a little fella, a little roux, and he would put his toys in the pouch.
Don't put your toys in your pouch.
Never put your toys there.
Yes.
What did he say?
He said head.
Head?
Head, yeah.
Well, I'm never going to let him defend me. I said thumb.
Thumb? Yeah.
Don't put your thumb in your pouch.
Well, now, what do mothers always say to their sons, Charles?
Don't put your thumb in your pouch.
No.
Don't put your finger in your nose. Finger in your pouch.
Oh, all right. No? Well, I understand your logic and your reasoning there.
How was the imitation? Anything worth saving?
Joanne, how many times do I have to tell you, don't put your blank in your pouch?
Hands?
Hands is what the mothers always say.
You.
You know, mothers always say, don't put your hands in your pockets.
My mother never said that.
And that would be the thing. Okay.
My mother said
that.
Hilarious.
There it is. Yeah, isn't that what mothers always say, Betty?
I hate to bring up a sore point, but if she said, son, don't put whatever in your pouch, boy, kangaroos don't have pouches. Or pikes, as the case may be. Don't put your bicycle in your pouch.
It would be a little lumpy in there, wouldn't it, with a bicycle? It never occurred to me that little boy kangaroos don't have pouches, but we take that as dramatic license here, just to...
You mean poetic.
I mean poetic, because, you see, otherwise we'd have to tear up the question and not be able to use it if we didn't have that kind of opportunity today. Okay, here we go, round three. Now, let's see. Sherry, you're still ahead, so we'll ask you to go first again.
I've been doing so well with B. I'll take that again.
A.
B.
B.
Right.
Okay. All right, Marge said, just had a blind date with a doctor.
Oh, boy.
At the end of the evening, we came back to my house, and he gave me a blank. Okay. All right, Sherry. Marge said, thank you for turning on the lights. Yeah. Marge said, I just had a blind date with a doctor. At the end of the evening, we came back to my house, and he gave me a blank.
Examination.
She said examination. What do you say to that, sir?
Of course, he did give her a bill, but he also gave her a physical.
A physical. Okay, there's one for Sherry. Yes, I'm over here now.
Yes, now.
No, over here.
Pardon. He gave her a physical.
Physical.
Of a non-medical variety.
Oh, that's interesting. What do you got?
They had to take all the plastic flowers off the kitchen table. Physical.
Hey, physical. Isn't it fun when you match in the first round? You just sit here and watch the parade go by and everything?
No pressure.
Yes. At the end of the evening, we came back to my house and he gave me a...
Get physical, please.
A physical. Five for Sherry.
Joanna's getting the hang of this game.
Yes.
I think this is a match. He gave her an eye test. It was a blind date.
An eye test.
Well, it was an examination of sorts.
Just had a blind date with a doctor. Then he gave me, the eye test.
Think about it. Don't be angry.
So there we are. Five for her. That means, Kevin, you must match five to achieve a tie, six to win a game. Lois Lane said. You know who Lois Lane is?
Yeah.
Of course. She said, now that Superman is old... He's retired from crime fighting. All he does these days is stand on the street corner showing off his shriveled blank.
I know who Lois Lane is. She's Priscilla and Lola's sister.
Yes, Priscilla. Oh, I was so in love with Priscilla Lane. I'm still in love with Priscilla Lane.
When?
Rosemary.
Yes. And Rosemary, yes. Okay, everybody ready? Here we go, Kevin. Lois Lane said, now that Superman is old, he's retired from crime fighting. All he does these days is stand on the street corner showing off his shriveled blank.
Body.
Body.
Oh, Kevin!
Kevin, you do know who Superman is.
Yeah, I guess.
All right. Richard, what do you say?
His shriveled S. No, his cape.
His shriveled cape. Now, you must match everybody else, Kevin, to achieve a tie and stay in the game. What do we got from Brett?
Kevin, his shriveled S.
His shriveled S. If the S was in the front there, that means Sherry wins the game. Congratulations to you. Little blue dot, if you would, please. Well, Kevin, good luck to you in your legal career. You're going to do very well, I suspect, because you did badly here. As a lawyer, you will be terrific, Kevin. A wonderful lawyer. thought he'd never leave. Now I got a little message for America, then we'll see him back. Yeah, she does. All right, here we go with Sherry Cloutier. It's time now for a big money super match where you can win over $20,000. Now, Sherry, to do that, we're going to have two audience matches for you here. Here we go with the first one. We polled a studio audience some time ago, and we said, you write down your best answer to this, hole in blank. If you match the answer they gave most frequently, you get $500. For matching their second most popular answer, $250. And then if you match the third, you get $100. Three of our six stars will help you.
Richard Dawson, please.
Hole in one.
Hole in one.
Joanne?
Hole in the head.
Hole in the head.
And Betty White.
What do you got there, Betty?
I don't know. From a hole in the ground.
Hole in the ground. So we got hole in the ground, hole in the head, and hole in one. You may choose one of those or think up one of your own.
I'll go with hole in one.
Hole in one is what we want. Well, they're with you, aren't they? Let's see what we got here under the $100 response. Hole in the head. All right, that's a good omen for you, Sherry. May we see the $250 answer? Hole in the wall. I bet it's going to be there. A big hole in one. Here we go. Yeah! Attaboy, yes. Now, Sherry, you've won $500, which means the least you can be playing for is 10 times that amount, or $5,000. We're going to see now how much more you can win with the second audience match. Here we go. Slide it. Lame blank. Lame blank. Again, three of the six will help.
Oh. Richard?
Lame duck.
Oh. All right.
Brett Summers?
Thank you.
Just a minute. Just a moment here.
She's thinking.
Lame.
Leg of lame.
Leg of lame?
Lame brain.
Lame brain.
And Charles?
Charles, you gave her your good answer now.
Lame.
He didn't give me anything.
Oh, good. Good. They didn't notice, did they?
No.
Lame excuse.
So, lame excuse, lame duck, and lame brain are the three. Remember, you can choose one of those or give us one of your own.
I'll go with lame brain.
Lame brain. That's one that Brett gave you. All right, there may be a lame brain around here. May we see the $100 response, if you please? Lame horse.
Who was here that day?
Finally. All right, let's see the next one, if you please. Lame brain. Congratulations, you've got it. Is it going to be lame duck?
Yes.
No? What?
Duck.
Cool it. Go.
Lamb.
Duck it is. Now, you've won another $250 multiplied by 10. Makes $2,500. We add that to the previous $5,000 you won. Makes a grand total of $7,500. Now, that's the least you can play for. However, we'll walk up here to the star wheel, and we're going to determine which star you'll be playing with and for how much money. Because if it stops in any of the gold-starred areas, you will double your money. You'll be playing for $15,000 instead of $7,500. Give it a good spin. It must make one complete revolution. There it is.
Double, double.
Now, let's see if we get a double out of it for Sherry here. A double. A double. All right, you'll be playing with Charles Nelson Reilly for $7,500. Come back down here, if you would, please. And here we go. Chuck, you ready?
Yo!
All right. Good luck to you, my dear. It reads, moth blank. M-O-T-H blank. All right, Chuck is ready. Are you ready to give us a response to this to match him for $7,500? Moth?
Balls.
Moth balls. Okay.
No, it's difficult to play this game because it brings back a childhood. When I was in school, they used to say I had a lot of flakes. So I wrote flakes.
You have $8,250. Very, very happy. Is that anybody out there rooting for you? Well, we're all rooting for Sherry Cloutier, who won a big bundle of money. And while we're celebrating, we'll pass along a message or two to you.
Well, here we are. We're all very happy for Sherry, who has $8,250 with the help of our celebrities.
And we hope you'll join us next week for Match Game PM, where we want to give away another bundle of money, and we'll have another beautiful bunch of stars like these. Gene Rayburn here. Join us next time for Match Game PM. Goodbye.